Subscribe to the channel iMobiTalk and then press the bell icon next to it for getting updates and infos for the latest smartphones. And it's free. Hi friends, welcome to iMobiTalk. One company, BBK Electronics, Chinese company, owns 39% of the Indian market share. First of all, I'm not here to criticize or praise or promote any brand or company as such, but I'm just here to narrate facts. Now, you know what are the subsidiaries of BBK Electronics, Oppo, Vivo, and the OnePlus. I'm not here to talk about OnePlus because this is completely online. All the devices, all the handsets are sold online, but the Oppos and the Vivos, which owns a major share in the offline market, is something that I will be discussing further in this video. Keep watching this video because I will be discussing what are the plans, business strategies by these two big brands, Oppos and Vivos, and how the device which is being sold by these two brands do not install quality substance, quality goods inside their handsets. Keep watching. This is Pradeep and you're watching iMobiTalk. And one more thing, for the subsidiaries, the Oppos and the Vivos are always, I'm talking about the sellers, the distributors, they always consider Oppos and Vivos as the best brand because they get a very high margin compared to any other brands. So keep watching this video. This is Pradeep and you're watching iMobiTalk. Oppo and Vivo made their mark in the Indian mobile phone industries, in the offline market especially, because of a lot of factors, but one of the critical factor is empowering the partnership. I'll tell you about this factor in detail, but just to start from the beginning, there was a time when the offline market was not going very good because the margin which these distributors, phone distributors, were getting were very less. In fact, companies like Samsung, mostly which used to operate in the offline industry, did not used to give good margin to all the distributors and the sellers of their devices. Online is what most of the brands which are trying to reach the Indian customers were trying to sell. In fact, the online market was so famous that every brand which is launched in India after the advent of the Flipkart and the Amazon never tried to go into the offline market because the price which they will be selling online will be really less and the people will prefer buying it online rather going offline because there is a distribution cost and going to the market, logistic cost and a lot of things and a lot of additional costs are there which the customer has to bear when they buy it. But when they go online, they don't have to bear such costs. I hope I'm able to explain why online market, most of the phones which you buy online are not that high price. Mostly when you compare the phone price of a phone, the offline price is of course more expensive compared to the online ones. Okay, so this is what was the scenario some time back, but Oppo and Vivo, they saw this opening in the offline industry and they tried their hand. So what they are doing, they are giving a very high margin to the distributors, to the sellers. A very good margin, approximately more than 10% of the original price, and to promote it, they are also endorsing it through the celebrities. You are getting what I'm saying. They are paying to Ranveer Singh and Deepika Padukone to promote their products, to promote their devices, and people are seeing this as a premium device and are going to the offline markets and buying it. Just one thing they are asking the distributors, to promote their company devices and their products, they are just asking one thing, that if you are selling Oppo phones or Vivo phones, you must color your shop or the place or the store where you are selling it in either green or blue. So you have to color it either green or blue and you have to put it in white markings as the name Vivo or the name Oppo. So this is how if you see most of the vendors outside offline mostly, you will see the green and the blue taggings at the top. So mostly when you are outside, you'll not see any Samsung tags or any Huawei tag or any Xiaomi tags, but you will always see Oppo and Vivo tags, the green and the blue. So this is how they are really into the Indian market, and they are selling their devices very successfully. Now, just one more thing. Ultimately, how are they able to give such high margins to all the distributors and the sellers? Because if you see Oppo's and Vivo phones, they don't have high premium quality goods inside their phones. The techs that they are using, mostly the processors, it's of MediaTek. Even if it's very high priced, MediaTek processors are very cheap processors, and they don't have a lasting quality. Snapdragons are always the best, but they never install Snapdragon because it's expensive. So they buy cheap processors like MediaTek and they install it into the device. Apart from that, even the screen resolution you see, it's only 720, it's like normal HD, not even high HD. So this is how they are maintaining the cost to be very less, and they are selling at higher price by endorsing it through distributors, sellers, and the celebrities. So initially, if you see, I never used to promote any Oppo phones or the Vivo phones, but again, it's a business, it's the perception, it's the mindset which the buyers have in buying them, and of course they go for it and buy it. Of course, an educated, no, let's not have any further discussion on this. So I hope I'm able to portray, explain you exactly why Oppo's and Vivo phones maintain high margin, and the price that at which they are selling is not exactly the price of the device. In fact, it is way too high. Okay, put in your thumbs below and do subscribe to the channel, and do subscribe it so that I can bring you such nice and important information. Keep watching iMovie Talk and have a nice day.